Canada going for their eighth Olympic gold, Sweden going for their third.
That will be the last of the pleasantries between those two gentlemen. They exchange pennants, a little bit frosty, no smiles. Head coach Martz, considered one of the great hockey minds in the game, reigning world champion, and Mike Babcock, Stanley Cup ring, an Olympic gold medal. This is a great coaching matchup, actually, between two of the game's best coaches.
Gold medal game underway. Canada in their red and white playing from left to right. Goal guarded by Henrik Lundqvist for the Swedes, who are in their three-kroner outfit. The yellow and the blue. That's immediately played down the ice for Daniel Sedin to try and control it. Does control it quite well. It looked like it might be going for an icing for a while, but Jimmy Eriksson intervenes. Here's Jonathan Eriksson with Cromwell going down left wing. Here comes a shot from Sedin. Took a little ricochet. Rebound. It goes all the way into the glove. Nice, acceptable glove of Carey Price in the Canadian net. Daniel Sedin with a 1+4 so far.
With Backstrom out of the lineup, a little bit difficult. A little bit more difficult for Sweden, but he'll be huge today if they're going to have any success against Canada.
Patrick Berglund in the face-off circle for the time being until he gets thrown out, which he might be in a moment. Nope, referee's quite happy to let him carry on. Face-off with him and Patrice Bergeron. And the Canadians have their first real skate down the ice with Crosby playing it around the boards. Chris Kunitz will pick it up on left wing, just behind the back of the Swedish net. Swedes with Berglund to clear. Bergeron putting pressure on him, so it can't be released easily, and now will be by Steen. Kunitz nearly took it off his stick. Bergeron with the chance, and the first save made by Lundqvist. The feed from Sidney Crosby to Bergeron. And Bergeron very close to getting an opening goal. Well, maybe it is going to be more of a wide-open match than we'd anticipated. Getzlaff. Tied on the boards with Corey Perry. Getzlaff trying to win it in the corner. Pushed still further in by Johansson. That's not going to be released easily.
It's Getzlaff, Perry, Ben line has been huge for Team Canada. All guys on this line, 6'2", 6'3", big body presences, working hard on the wall. And you see right now they have the Swedes hemmed in.
Getzlaff, short side. Dig, dig, dig for Jamie Benn. Jamie Benn saw it. Then it was immediately snaffled by Lundqvist, but it was there long enough for Jamie Benn to get a poke in there. And it's not been the most comfortable first minute and a half for Henrik Lundqvist. He had that chance with Bergeron.
Is excellent hand-eye coordination right there. He actually takes the puck, almost looked like a lacrosse move there, took it out of the air, across for Bergeron. Here's Jamie Benn on the dig. Good save there by Lundqvist.
First two strikes, if you like, for the Canadians. First two attempts on goal from them. Brought out of defense for the Swedes by Jonathan Eriksson. Not too far ahead for Jakob Silfverberg, who will follow it into the corner, try and release it for Carl Hagelin, who made himself into a possible outlet for the pass. Back around it comes from Eriksson again. Swedes formulating something, or at least trying to. Here's the captain, Cromwell. Plays it around the boards. 50-50 again, which the Swedes come up with. Hagelin still tied on that board, and will it eventually be released? It might possibly be by Hagelin, but they just worked it around from the back of the boards to the side of the boards, and now it has come loose for Eriksson. Cromwell will have a go. Has a go, but Carey Price is there to meet it.
Sweden take advantage of a line change there by Canada. Stretch pass for Cromwell, big slap shot down the wing. Important to note that both teams' leading point getters our defenders. There's a nice stretch pass. Cronwall leans into that. Price way outside the blue paint. Doughty leads Canada. Carlson leads Sweden.
The impressive Canadian defense has scored a lot of goals. Shea Weber, Drew Doughty, of course, with the four. In fact, they are still outscoring the Canadian forwards. The defense have the bragging rights in that. So maybe today is the day they're going to change all that round. We'll have to wait and see. Jonathan Taves puts the brakes on, looks up at his options, tight on the boards on right wing, being held in there by Eriksson for a moment. Will be released to Erik Karlsson. Karlsson down right wing. Man to arrive in the centre, looking for the pass is Eriksson, but it'll be helped away by Duncan Keith, one of those returning from Vancouver 2010, another gold medalist 4 years ago, looking to add to his collection today. And Keith rips it around the boards. Aduya Then meets Bergeron coming in the other direction. Pressure put on the goalie by Chris Kunitz. And then down goes Nicholas Kjell-Marsen. Referee says there's nothing there. And what a chance for Patrice Bergeron in front of net. But Patrice Bergeron hasn't given up on this yet. I hope that he and Kunitz can combine. Berglund hasn't got it over the... and then full stretch, Patrice Bergeron just sticks it wide. Swedes, it was a wide open game, much more wide open than we thought it might be early on here. It is end-to-end stuff after 4 minutes. As yet, only the two shots each for Sweden and Canada. And great chance again for Bergeron close in. Now, can the Swedes find Hagelin, who again is the spare man? Hagelin does well, little backhand wrister nearly into the bottom corner. Read though by Carey Price. Well, here's Drew Doughty. It's loose in front. Oh, nearly Carl Hagelin. He's been causing an awful lot of problems in making himself available quite often and then just making a complete rush either from the back of the goal or to the side of it.
Nyquist with a great rush here, hits the post, goes in behind Price, just stays out. Excellent play by Nyquist. Interesting so far, Crosby with two shifts. Neither shift has gotten that matchup that we thought. Cronwall. But now, the first time the matchup, Crosby out to Cronwall, jumps out in double shifts. Crosby had two shifts without 55 guarding him. Now, Coach Martz gets that matchup.
Eriksson thrown out of the face-off circle. In comes Daniel Sedin to compete for it. And the Swedes don't have it initially, and the Canadians can work it away with Kunitz. Kunitz attempt to get it to both Crosby and Bergeron. It's not successful. Sedin takes it over to left wing and will fire it in on the net. They're going to have a policy, it would seem here, the Swedes are just shooting on sight when there's a possibility. Jeff Carter is somebody that we will look for to maybe open things up, because he had that hat-trick early in the events. Nicholas Cornwall in the back of the goal and give it to Eriksson. Forward goes Johansson. Gone round two, gone round three. Has to go around the referee as well as he puts the brakes on. Johansson back to the point for the shot through traffic. Still loose. That shot was a decent one from Carlson, occupying that area just inside the blue line. He'll go and chase. Rick Nash will try and close him down. He does, bumps him into the boards. Reflection en route, so the retrieving job will be done by Edler. Carlson. Johansson. Oh, and Carey Price gets that and sticks it away. He has another save to make almost immediately. Swedes are shooting virtually on sight, whether it's straight on or from an angle. And they have accumulated five. And they got a little while to start their proceedings, but they've got five now.
That's smart by Sweden. They know Canada has been leading the tournament in shots, trying to keep Price on his toes early, and nearly had one with Nyquist.
Edler to Steen. Crisp passing by the Swedes. Berglund was the man waiting in front, but the Canadians will be able to clear halfway and against quite a big breakout from them. Jeff Carter, I mentioned before, he's just hovering around the front of that crease. Having to go wide, then coming back more central, looking for the pass to come in from Patrick Marleau. Jonathan Toews. Should be helped away by Hjalmarsson. Gets it just about over the blue line. Comes back in, though, with Jeff Carter. Carter will now get to the bench and look for a line change. And Swedes also change. 6 minutes and 20 gone. Alexander Steen was waiting up top for the pass that didn't quite come. Perry bounces off the boards. Getzlaff following him. Getzlaff and Marcus Kruger. Here's the captain, Cronwall. Option to his left is Eriksson. Eriksson's the way he goes. Bypass the stick of Kruger. Will be played by Vlasic. 7 minutes gone. First, Doughty rips it around the boards. Gets that ball, chase in. Patrice Bergeron waits for it to arrive with him. It doesn't. Comes to Edler instead, who'll advance it over the red, over the blue, and then put a shot in again. First time attempt once more by the Swedes, who are shooting pretty much every time they get a sighter or any get in the vicinity of the Canadian goal. They're shooting right now.
There's Erik Karlsson, leads Sweden in points, 4 goals, 4 assists, a +5, 17 shots here in Sochi. Dynamic offensive player off the blue line for Canada. Drew Doughty, 4 goals, 2 assists, 6 points, 13 shots. He's a +3. So blue liners leading the way for these two finalists here in the gold medal game. An excellent period there by Matt Duchesne. Matt Duchesne in the preliminary round for Canada was the extra forward. He was a good teammate. He said in the mix zone he'd be willing to do anything just to be here. He was that extra forward. He didn't play a lot in the preliminary round. Jonathan Tavares hurt against Latvia, hit by Artur Kulda. A knee injury has ended Tavares' tournament. So Duchesne knew he had to be ready to play here, keep in the right mindset. He's come in. Excellent first period so far for Duchesne, Colorado Avalanche. Good season for him in the NHL. 19 goals, 31 assists, 50 points. Real jump in his step. And he was out on the bench before the pregame warm-up, just listening to music, drinking some water, getting visualizing this game. Matt Duchesne, a good start.
Shots on goal, 6-2 to Sweden, early stages, but nothing to show for it yet. But Carey Price has had quite a bit of work to do in the last few minutes after an early onslaught on the Henrik Lundqvist goal. Swedes are changing their policy around from what we saw against the Finns. And, indeed against the Swiss, where they were a little bit inept, a little bit lifeless when it came to goal-scoring opportunities. Only beat the Swiss by 1-0, but this team has emerged and has started to get better as the tournament's gone on. Again, playing around the boards. Daniel Sedin following into the corner. Will be followed into the corner by Petrangelo. It does well to emerge with it for the Canadians. Forward goes Jay Boumeester having a go. And the deflection comes off the arm of Henrik Lundqvist. And he can be satisfied, reasonably so, with his first 8 minutes as we look at how Sweden got to this final.
Yeah, what a run they're on. 5-0, haven't dropped a point. Big wins over the Czech Republic. And, of course, that Finland game, a classic in the semifinal. Good shot by Boumeester there. Good reaction save by Lundqvist. Boumeester, that big assist on the Jamie Benn goal to put Canada through 1-0 over the USA.
And a face-off won by the Swedes, but only just. And battling away is Hjalmarsson trying to keep possession for the Swedes, but the Canadians, as you might expect, harrying and hassling. And I'm not so shot on the turn, but actually a dump into the corner by Bergeron in the end. Chris Kunitz is tied up for the moment, but then works his way clear. But the Swedes have the puck. Playing the route of going back behind their own goal. And then Aduya cuts across to right wing. Sees a man to help him out. It's Hjalmarsson. The slow but steady build up this time by the Swedes. But they lose it in central ice. The neutral ice zone being Canada's at the moment. Corey Perry and Jamie Benn can't quite combine. And away comes Kruger for the Swedes. Plays it around the back of the boards. That's Alexander Steen do a bit of chasing. Chasing in vain, though. Gets that with Perry, Wenny on right wing. The offside call is made as Drew Doughty goes for a little bit of a dive over the blue line.
Canada. Excellent, excellent tournament for Mike Babcock's crew. United States, that big win, the 1-0 semifinal win. An excellent display of defensive prowess by Canada.
Berglund wins the face-off. Edler for the Swedes as they make their way forward. Carlson will be the danger man. So we know he's got a good shot, got defensive capabilities, but when he's let them go during the course of the event, it's been pretty decent and very accurate. That's one of the reasons why the Swedes are where they are here. Edler will have to go the long way around. We'll cut it back for the shot. But checked away. Alfredsson has to come back to his own half of the ice. Edler now has got a bit of one open ice to patrol. The touch from Erik Karlsson nearly found its way through. Just mentioning how dangerous a customer he can be in front of net. Carlson had the trailing stick, was looking for the little ricochet, the little rebound. Wasn't too far away. Quick release by Carter. He will find Patrick Marleau in front of goal. Acting as a screen there for a while was Carter. Then White and Jonathan Taves will pick it up for the Canadians. They'll keep it in the zone. Try and work it around the perimeter one more time. Jonathan Taves has it. Just played it a bit too far behind Jeff Carton. Carton can't quite keep it in the zone, and the Swedes will swarm forward with Silverberg. Good backtracking, good retrieving by Boomies to get back and prevent the Swedes from getting a good open look in front. Silverberg wheeling around once, twice, and then again. Trying to play it down the boards on right wing, but again it's intercepted. Things are doing very well with making sure that they don't get a good look at the moment, and it was Alex Petriangelo in the corner, finding a way to stop the Swedes advancing to that danger area around the front of Carey Price's net. He has had 7 shots on his and 3 on Henrik Lundqvist at the other end.
Excellent sustained pressure by Sweden. Berglund was trouble, Haglund was trouble. It's a nice pass there, and there's Carlson, who leads them in points. Excellent deflection there, Price up to the task, but there was a sequence of play there. As you look at the Swedish coaching staff, Granberg and Popovic, the assistants to Martz, but there was a sequence of play there where Patrick Berglund just couldn't be dispossessed along the wall, using his 6'4" frame to cycle the puck in the Canadian zone. Excellent, excellent start from Team Sweden. Mike Babcock joined by Julian Ruff and Hitchcock. That's a lot of experience behind the Team Canada bench.
Half of the team have returned from Vancouver 2010. Roberto Luongo obviously not in goal this time, not between the pipes. Duncan Keith, Shea Weber, Drew Doughty, people like that. Patrick Marlowe, Ryan Getzlaff, all back. Know what it's like to win gold. They did it 4 years ago, the hard way, by beating the Americans in overtime for that Sidney Crosby goal. Sidney Crosby also back, captaining the Canadians, and trying to win a face-off up against Jimmy Eriksson. Important face-off to win for the Canadians as they were camped down their own end of the ice. Just Bergeron and Crosby will try and combine. It's come back the other direction. Here is Crosby helping out on defensive duties, not particularly effectively yet, though. Kunitz has had some really good chances. Now Bergeron will have another chance. Maybe he can shoot, and he hits a post. Hits the pipe, deflected off Henrik Lundqvist, and hit the pipe. Closest the Canadians have come to finding a way through. Louis Eriksson, loads of space. Daniel Sedin, well, he was until he got closed down. Got the pass away, though, to Kruger, arriving on right wing. Kruger trying to work it with the skates, then working it with the stick. I guess Hjalmarsson will have to go back and help out on defensive cover with Johnny Oduya. Oduya picks out Sedin, and then one-timer for Marcus Kruger. Gets the deflection, goes up into the stop netting, and we stop the clock at 8:32.
Great shot, Patrice Bergeron. Off the back foot, post. Had Lundqvist beat. Nyquist hit the post earlier for Sweden. Right there, Bergeron for Canada.
We await our first goal. 8:30 to go in the first. And that's been momentum swings on both sides here. Nobody really dominating early stages. Jamie Benn for the Canadians. It's cleared away by Johnny Oduya, helped still further clear by Hagelin. We'll come back with the Canadians, and no penalty needs to be called. The referee waved that off. He obviously thought that somebody might suggest it, but we have gone 12 minutes without the referee having to call the penalty on either side. Let him play. Nice wide open game. It's exactly what we wanted to see in the gold medal game. Drew Doughty, we know he can shoot it. Normally, more accurately than that. To a deflection on route, though. Here's Marlowe. Carter, drop pass to Taves, then Weber. Weber, too, has registered quite a few goals already in the competition. Both those two, Doughty and Weber. Very effective from just inside the blue line. Sweet out with Patrick Berglund. Hasn't got anybody else near him in the yellow shirt. Now he will have, because Steen is there. They'll try and force that puck through traffic, but back it comes in the other direction. Patrick Marlowe drills one in low, hits the side of the net. I think some people in the crowd thought it might have snuck in, but it actually rippled the side of the net. Weber gets an open look at a pass for Jeff Carter. Carter right across the crease, and they score! It's Jonathan Taves who gets the last touch for Canada. And they open the scoring at 12:55. Jeff Carter with a perfect feed right into the perfect position. And Jonathan Taves is there to poke it home. Canada on the board after 12:55.
Excellent cycle play. Perfect pass. soft hands by the Chicago Blackhawks captain, two-time Stanley Cup champion. Gets the inside on the Swedish defender. And you can see not even a smile from Mike Babcock. Knows that's just one part of this game. Sweden, so dangerous. One goal, nothing to get excited about if you're Mike Babcock, but an important goal for Jonathan Toews. Carter and Weber, the assist. Excellent pass by Jeff Carter.
What a poker player Mike Babcock would make. Gives nothing away, no indication, no emotion, nothing whatsoever. But he's looking at the clock going, well, that's 12:59 gone. Loads to go, yeah.
Excellent saucer pass there. Nice feather. Drops down perfectly in the crease right there. Perfect deflection by Toews. Canada open up the scoring. After a post from each side, Toews with a huge goal.
So he's just about out shooting the Canadians, 7-5, but at the moment that doesn't mean a whole load because the Canadians have their noses in front. Toews from Carter and Shea Weber getting a secondary assist on that. Jonathan Toews gets a very important goal. And the Canadians have the first imprint on the scoreboard. Remember, they were pretty much in control for the most part against the USA 4 years ago, and the USA suddenly came up with that late riposte. That goal being scored in the very last minute. First goal from 8 attempts in terms of shooting for Jonathan Toews here in Sochi 2014. Bergeron tries another attempt on Henrik Lundqvist. No way there through for him.
Important to mention as well, Canada, we showed the list of their coaches, but they have a consultant, Ralph Kruger, who was brought in here by Babcock. You see Bergeron still looking for his first goal, but Kruger was brought in here to help Canada have a game plan to play on the big ice, and we saw that game plan executed to perfection against Team USA.
A man who will be advising Southampton Football Club during the latter stage of this season. Well, Swedes just rocked back on their heels a bit after having a decent period of pressure for about 5 or 10 minutes. Carlson lets that go from distance, and Carey Price had it the second attempt. I think there were a few oohs and ahs behind the back of his goal. Some people that it might have snuck out, but well, this man's been on form for the Swedes.
Haglund, nice wrist shot there, good glove save. Hagman's been very good. Haglund, 2 goals in the tournament. Nearly catches Price there, holds on, no rebound, which is what was so good against Team USA. Very few rebound opportunities on Price.
And after Cassini a couple early on, the Canadians have been very frugal. Their defense has been stoic, and their minders let nothing pass them. That's a shutout, the USA. USA shut out in 2 games back-to-back at the medal stage. Marlow for the Canadians, but then the Swedes have it back. With a bit of wide open ask for Carlson to work in, but before he does, Shea Weber hands a stick on it and deflects it away with Duncan Keith just holding on till the line change is made for the Canadians. Few new bodies come on for the Swedes as well. Shea Weber will advance it for them. Here's Matt Duchesne, good shot on target.
Martin Saint-Louis with his first shift for Canada. They play Steve Stamkos, who never recovered from a broken leg. Saint-Louis hasn't played a lot, but has been good when out.
And here he is, fighting for the puck, getting the shot in. Again, the feed by Rick Nash. And Martin Saint-Louis might combine with Matt Duchesne here. It's going to be a penalty call on the Swedes. Duchesne goes down as soon as the puck is touched by Eriksson. It's going to be a holding call. He's not happy, having a chat with the referee. Doesn't feel that's the right time to make that kind of call, but the call has been made, and Jonathan Eriksson of the Detroit Red Wings is on his way to sit it out for 2 minutes.
Eriksson sits right there. Duchesne puts the left hand out, sweeps the stick away. Eriksson has no chance to do anything else except put a hand on him. Canada 2-for-9 on the power play, 22.2% with the man advantage here in Sochi. And Duchesne, as I mentioned, didn't play a lot in the preliminary round. An excellent move inside out. There's a shot. Lundqvist had to be quick. Nash on the rebound. swept away there by Louis Eriksson. And Saint-Louis hasn't played a lot, but when he has been in there, he's been dangerous. Diminutive player, always a big point producer for the Tampa Bay Lightning, a Stanley Cup champion. Good shot there on Lundqvist.
And give you a chance at the right point age, 39 now? Martin Saint-Louis. It sometimes comes to those who wait. He had to wait a long, long time. Wasn't on the original roster, but flew over a few days before the competition started with everybody else. So, power play for the Canadians. It starts down the Swedish end of the ice with Kunitz. Swedes are normally pretty good at killing off these power plays, but they're up against a very forceful and team who have a lot of incision in their power play. Keith then, shot coming in from Patrick Sharp. Crosby's available to the right. Here is Crosby. He'll try and drill it through. No, he doesn't. Actually, tries to set the play up for Sharp instead. Sharp and Kunitz waiting on the left wing and center. Find it off the boards, flipped up in the air, but not very far away by Niklas Hjalmarsson. Now they get it away, and Kruger will put pressure. Okay, Keith just guards it round the back of the Canadian net.
Excellent active stick by Jimmy Eriksson. That was a slap pass by Crosby through the crease. Eriksson, active stick, deflects it away. Good play by Eriksson for Sweden.
Getzlaff arriving in the center. Getzlaff now at the back of the net. Needs to find himself a bit more central to help out with the pass from Shea Weber. Corey Perry will follow it into the corner, as will Jonathan Toews. Should be released by the Canadians and is. Doughty's got a great shot. He's got working inside off. Well, he was going to go for a first attempt there, go for the one-timer, but he didn't. He wants to set it up from different areas. He's a bit too far advanced from where he likes to be. He likes to be back where he is right now. Ryan Getzlaff will maybe play it through traffic. We'll look for the man in front. That man in front is Corey Perry. Corey Perry still battling for it. And away they will get it, will the Swedes. Carl Hagelin. And back it will come with 20 seconds remaining on the power play for the Canadians. Doughty stayed out there. Doughty puts it right back onto the, nearly onto the tape of the stick of Shea Weber, but not quite. Getzlaff forward to Marlow. Getzlaff, and that was a bit short, that pass. The direction was good for Corey Perry, but not the amount of application, the amount of force behind it. And clock stops at 3:02, and the Canadian power play has gone.
Good job of collapsing in front there. You see Cronwall sees the mismatch with Perry, jumps in there. Toews is in there as well, but an excellent job right there by the captain, Cronwall. And Lundqvist battling hard to get that and freeze it.
Bergeron, yes, Johansson then. One time for Rick Nash, but collects the defenseman en route. We'll get a second look at that. So they try to go through bodies with Patrick Marleau waiting right in front of Henrik Lundqvist's goal.
Team Canada changing up their lines. Bergeron started with Crosby. He's out there with Marleau and Nash right now. So Babcock shuffling the deck, keeping Sweden on the back foot. A couple of different looks from Team Canada early on.
Eriksson with Cronwall, especially him down, maybe more influence in the game early on. Good pad save from the shot from Landeskog from Carey Price. Shots are pretty even, actually. Canada just edging in front. They're 11-9 ahead at this stage, where the Swedes were dominating things after the initial exchanges between them. Marteau Saint-Louis works it open, and then the backhand just didn't quite find its target. Saint-Louis getting quite a bit of ice time here. Crosby, here comes the attempt, which goes over the top of the goal from Jamie Benn. Benn lets it go behind him. Saint-Louis right in front one more time, and will be cleared by Gabriel Landeskog into neutral territory.
Crosby out there with Saint-Louis and Kunitz. So again, another look from Babcock as the Perry gets off Ben line, jumps over the boards now. Babcock not afraid to change things up on the fly.
Shea Weber with a good direct shot, as he's so used to doing. There's always a lot of force and power behind those shots as well. Goalies cannot take him for granted. Berglund also work it down right wing, gets dispossessed by a Vlasichor player all around the boards. And the Canadians trying to keep it for their possession, but the Swedes battling to win it back, and that's what they've done so often in this competition, is battle back. Here's Hjalmarsson. We'll wait and see who's going where. Sedin's going to his right, going to his left is Jimmy Eriksson. Eriksson will dump it in. First to it should be Drew Doughty, and Doughty has a little bit of time in which to caress the puck round behind him and give it to Patrick Marleau. Forward again, go to the Canadians in very quick transition. Jeff Carter works his way loose for Jonathan Toews. Toews with Marleau. Marleau just slightly ill-directed pass goes back over the blue line and back down to the Canadian end of the ice. Shea Weber. Looking for Duncan Keith. The two of them can advance the puck without too many yellow shirts around them. There's going to be a penalty on the play. It's going to be on the Canadians. Tell you more about it when it happens. Hagelin, and what is the referee spotted? He doesn't like it. High sticking call. And that means we're going to have a power play for the Swedes, and the man to make his way is Chris Kunitz.
Bit of a pitchfork there into the face of Marcus Kruger. An easy call there for Kelly Sutherland. Kunitz still looking for a goal in this tournament. Familiar with Sidney Crosby, they both play for Pittsburgh, that just haven't come together here. And as we mentioned, a good power play unit. 7 for 19, Sweden. Babcock wouldn't want too many opportunities, too many looks for Sweden.
Well, here comes the first of them, and as the old man of the team, Daniel Alfredsson at 41, getting that shot in. They might just have one more go from long range. Oh, that was a pinger from Erik Karlsson, which Carey Price got fully in behind. And managed to deflect it away from danger. That's one more attempt right at the very far end there.
It's the Jamie Benn opportunity off the rush. Good active stick there by Hagelin. Tips it up over Lundqvist's net. At the other end, a big block by Rick Nash on the penalty kill.
I should say going into period number two. 1:48 remaining on this power play for Sweden. Let's see how effective they can be and how direct and offensive they want to be from the off. It's back with Erik Karlsson in the second period. The Swedes playing from left to right. He's carrying all the way to the red line, then back, waiting for the pass to come out to Steen or perhaps to Alfredsson. Alfredsson goes to the top of the circle, in line with goal now, works his way back to the blue line and Karlsson. There's plenty of traffic in front, including Eriksson. Steen. First time from Eriksson, second time from Eriksson. Two saves made, three saves made, four saves made from Carey Price. Alfredsson will farm it out to the back of the goal to Sedin, who'll work it around in a semicircle. Sedin to Alfredsson, again looking for the route to goal. It doesn't exist. Sedin, Steen, and happily, from a Canadian point of view, Jonathan Toews is there to whip it away down to the Swedish end of the ice, but there was a rat-tat-tat around the front of the Canadian net for a while there, and he made all the saves he had to, Carey Price. Nyquist around the back of the Canadian net. We'll come back to whence it came from Hagelin. On the blue line, it's Karlsson. Trying to dig it out and get a good open look. It's Carl Hagelin. He might be able to do that with Marcus Kruger. Kruger has Nyquist waiting to pull the trigger. Goes to the top of the circle, works his way back to the blue line. 21 seconds all remains on this Swedish power play, which has not been anywhere near as effective, though they've had plenty of rubber heading the way of Carey Price's net. They might have another one here. Little drop past Kruger. Can't keep it under control. Kruger's going to try and win it back again. Got Carl Hagelin in his wake, and the power play is done, but they'll get one more shot on as the 5-on-5 is restored for the Canadians. Kunitz comes out of the box, and that was a busy, busy time there for Carey Price. Had to make a whole lot of saves.
Well, they say your best penalty killer has to be your goalie, and right there, Carey Price was definitely the best penalty killer on the ice for Team Canada. Several big saves, and then a nice play by Jonathan Toews there to get it out. Excellent aggressive penalty kill as well by Ben and Bergeron, pushing out on the points against Sweden, but Carey Price sensational there on the penalty kill for Canada.
Four shots registered as far as the people analyzing the game are concerned, taking Sweden up to 15-12 now over Canada. Sweden will try and be a bit more forceful. They need to be, of course. They're a goal behind, scored by Jonathan Toews. Hit on the side from Eriksson, didn't quite take the player flush. Vlasic down the ice for Saint-Louis. Saint-Louis will look to go and recapture the puck again for the Canadians playing around the boards. Crosby being held in for a moment, then being pulled down, but the referee doesn't see any reason to give a call, so no call is made, and the Swedes will work it out of defense. The man hovering on center red line has gone to the team bench now, Silverberg. 3 minutes gone in period number two. Canadians trying to find a way to get that puck back to Jamie Benn. Jamie Benn will see it fly past him. No icing call because it's intercepted on the blue line.
In the semi-final, we realized that Oliver Ekman-Larsson wasn't in Coach Mart's plan, didn't play any shifts at all. He was dressed, sat at the end of the bench. No time on ice for Oliver Ekman-Larsson in the first period. No time on ice for Henrik Tallander either.
But they need a deep bench if the scoreline stays the way it is. Berglund in a bit of a battle with Duchesne to try and work that puck loose. Boomeister's in there as well. Boomeister, it is, in fact, trying to find a way clear with Corey Perry helping out. Is it still there? Referee says he can see it. They're playing it with the sticks, they're playing it with the skate. Eventually does find his way out to Getzlaff. And the Canadians can start stream down the ice with Marlowe. Now Boomeister, bounce off the boards for Aduya to go and chase. Aduya comes essentially out from D, deflects it into the boards. That will be another whistle on the play at 16:02.
Corey Perry, offensively gifted player, Anaheim Duck, just one assist in the tournament. Of course, Corey Perry, 30 goals in the NHL this season. Hoping to break out here today. We mentioned a couple of Swedes not getting any ice time. Dan Hamhuis didn't play a shift for Canada in that first period. Extra defenseman and Martin Saint-Louis, a couple of good energy shifts, only a minute 12, so they'll have some fresh legs as this game starts to wear on if both coaches decide to go that way.
So 4 minutes gone in the second, and the Swedes had it, then they lost it, and Duchesne has it for them, then Nash had to go, and then did the shot come in? It certainly did, and the attempt from Martin Saint-Louis.
Rick Nash has looked really good. He looked really good against Team USA, had plenty of jump. Nice pass here, one-timer, Martin Saint-Louis. Didn't fully get all of it. Lundqvist had to make a big save. Nash has lots of jump, excellent, excellent pass there. Just towed there off the top of the blade by Martin Saint-Louis. As I mentioned, a minute 12 in that first period was good when he was out there for Canada, right there, perilously close for Sweden.
Bergeron wins the faceoff, comes again through traffic. The man waiting back on the point is Drew Doughty. He'll now go back on defensive duties because the Swedes are going to break out to their own defensive zone. Try and find Nyquist in center ice. Or possibly the other option is Marcus Kruger, who's advancing it down right wing but can't get much quality possession as it's cleared away by Vlasic. Partially cleared away, stays in the Canadian zone, bypasses the stick of Kunitz. Vlasic again, down left wing.
Bergeron back out there with Crosby and Kunitz. Patrice Bergeron led all shooters in that first period with 3 shots on goal. Actually, he hit the post as well, so we had a couple of really good opportunities, number 37 in red. But Crosby, Kunitz stayed together. Saint-Louis is rotated in there and Bergeron as well. There's Nicholas Jalmarsson, Stanley Cup champion, the Chicago Blackhawks. 4 goals, 19 assists in the NHL this season, the 26-year-old. Putting in big minutes for Sweden.
First 5 minutes of the second period gone. 15-13 in terms of shots on net in favor now of the Swedes, thanks to that power play which yielded 4. Seems that's been made in quick succession by Carey Price. Eriksson. Silverberg is waiting for the pass, but it bypasses him, and Eriksson will play it round the back of the net. Duncan Keith in a battle to keep it in Canadian possession and works the Oracle in that respect. Jonathan Toews working his way down right wing as he'll suddenly make a change. Patrick Marleau, good one for the pass in front of Jeff Carter to get the shot in. And that will disappear off the top of the boards.
Team Canada there looking at the referee to say the defenseman shot it over the glass. He says it's deflected. Brad Meyer of the USA, Kelly Sutherland of Canada. Here's the chance by Carter. Just ran out of real estate there. Lundqvist tracks him really well. Nowhere for Carter to go. Banged away at it there, but good save by Lundqvist.
Sweden gold medalists in 1994 when they beat the Canadians in a penalty shootout. That's a famous day for Peter Forsberg. Not such a famous day for Paul Kariya, but Paul Kariya returned with that winning team in 2002, so he eventually got his medal. Oh, we are going to see a penalty because Silverberg's going to sit it out for 2 minutes.
So the Canadian players won their battle there. One referee shook it off the other. They had a bit of a chat delaying the game. Silverberg, not a smart play there. Not under too much pressure, just threw it up high and over the glass.
Penalty for delaying the game on Silverberg. So 5-on-4 now for the Canadians. Drew Doughty, a useful man to have on this line. Jonathan Toews will work his way towards the net. Ryan Getzlaff as they recycle it. One more time for Drew Doughty. Doughty to Getzlaff. Getzlaff will have another attempt. Shea Weber on this line, also on right wing. Doughty is working his way across the blue line in case that puck comes back out to him. He's calling for it. He wants it. He goes stick raised. Weber just bounces over his stick and he just about keeps it in the zone. Another attempt maybe for Doughty, trying to work it back to him. They can't because the option they went for was Corey Perry instead. And then referee brings play to a halt. Getzlaff looks annoyed.
Excellent block by Johnny Oduya there. Keeping Canada the outside. Getzlaff looking for Perry. Just misses. Perry's been dangerous. 30 goal scorer as mentioned, still looking for his first goal here in Sochi. Sweden do a good job to keep him to the outside. A good block by Johnny Oduya just a few seconds after that.
Power play has 1:05 yet to run. Cromwell will use up a few of those seconds by whacking it down the ice and asking Duncan Keith to bring it back for the Canadians. And that's what he's going to do. With a little drop pass to Kunitz. Crosby's on this line, along with Patrick Sharp. Sharp battling for it, but again, the battling qualities of the Swedes, meaning that the Canadians don't have any quality play on this power play.
Excellent aggressive penalty killing there from Carl Hagelin. He was right on top of Sharp straight away. No time and space for number 10 in red to make a play. Excellent job defensively by Carl Hagelin.
And you got a chance to clear again. Eriksson will just whack it down the ice. 25 seconds remaining on this power play. Duncan Keith will retrieve the puck from the back of the goal. And try and set somebody up if indeed there is time. There may be for him. Spencer Crosby is waiting for the drop pass. They actually miss him out and give it to Jamie Benn instead. Doughty working his way in. Last 5 seconds, something needs to come pretty quickly. Corey Price is telling them just that. They need a shot. They get the shot. First time shot from Jamie Benn. Kicked out. Through the crease, oh, the trailing stick of Louis Eriksson nearly getting a touch. Eriksson was right on top of that, but it was about a meter, probably less than a meter away from him. Another one thrown in on that. Carey Price having to do a little dancing in that crease. Swedes will not be able to hold on to it for much longer. Corey Perry, gonna go a long way around. Got two defensemen between him and the goal. Gonna have to go 180 and then turn around. Playing off the boards, hoping that Duchesne could be the man on top of it. Canadians have the pass still, has to have the puck in their possession. Boomister making himself available. Louis Eriksson, though, for the Swedes. Dumped into the boards, dumped into the corner, and Boomister will wrap it around the boards on left wing. It'll come to Martin Saint-Louis, but he's offside as the puck arrives with him. The clock will stop. He looks annoyed that he took that extra step, but he did, according to the linesman. And 11-11 remaining in period number two, 5-2 in terms of shots on goal for Sweden and Canada.
Sedin dances into the zone, a rebound there, just jumps over the stick of Louis Eriksson. Toe save, Doughty with a little stick check there on Eriksson. Both of them reaching for the 50-50 puck. Eriksson hung his head, looked skyward. He had a yawning cage there. Lundqvist, a much-deserved drink there. Canada being outshot 16-14 by Sweden right now. Five shots in this second period for Sweden, two for Canada. Price, been magnificent. Great rebound control from Carey Price in this game. Albeit that one there, a toe save that kicked out to Eriksson. Carey Price has been as cool as a cucumber, looking very comfortable in the Canadian net. Lundqvist, he's been here before. He's done this before in 2006. Great goaltending matchup here at Bolshoi Ice Dome. Canada 0 for 2 on the power play. Sweden 0 for 1. The special teams, we talked about off the top, so important to take advantage of the man advantage. So far 0 for on both sides of the puck.
Still more dialogue going on between Jonathan Toews and the officials. The puck will eventually be dropped. He sticks down, boys. Duncan Keith to Weber. The move out from the back of the Canadian goal starts now with Keith trying to get it under control, but he's going to ice the puck and back they will come.
Good play by Louis Eriksson. Puts a body in there, forces Duncan Keith to make a play. There's Jeff Carter, who had that wonderful pass to Jonathan Toews. Three goals, two assists in Sochi. A plus six. Stanley Cup champion, the Los Angeles Kings, looking for a gold medal here in 2014.
Well, I was about to say the two number 16s would go head-to-head. But then Marcus Kruger got sent out of the face-off circle. Carlson, it's loose in front of Eriksson. Doesn't quite get the chance to have the tip he's looking for because Carey Price makes the save. And Eriksson seems to be getting closer and closer without actually having the shot to match.
Yeah, four goals, four assists here in the tournament. I just spoke about rebound control right there. Smothers the puck, Carey Price. Louis Eriksson dancing through the crease. No free biscuit there.
Keith for Canadians. We'll get it back to his captain, Sidney Crosby. In turn, gives it to Weber to advance down the ice. Chris Kunitz. Kunitz just trying to straddle that blue line, but they have to retreat because the Swedes overturn it. Johansson. Here he is once again. Here's Sidney Crosby. Flanked by two either side. Crosby trying to go all the way. Good poke check to get that puck away because Crosby was on his way maybe to his first goal of Sochi 2014. But luckily, from a Swedish point of view, flanked either side. The poke check stopped it getting through. But the Canadians still have possession and they're working hard to try and retrain it to retain it as well.
Erik Karlsson with an excellent stick check there on Crosby trying to break in.
Eriksson was trying to stream to the net, but just went a little bit too quickly. Linesman indicates that's offside. Johansson might have been the man to step over. Sidney Crosby, eyes must have lit up here because there was a good chance.
Excellent play. Steals the puck away from Johansson. Comes in there. Excellent stick check by Erik Karlsson. You know he's an offensive defenseman. Shows his defensive abilities right there. Great, great stick chase check on Sidney Crosby. Still looking for his first goal here in Sochi.
Vasic with gets left to the left. He wants to use him, but he's going to go right instead and bring it all the way out of defense. It's Drew Doughty. But again, the Swedes manage to overturn things and they get lots of players forward, including Patrick Berglund, who will pursue Drew Doughty into the corner, cleared away by Getzlaff. Now the open man is Jamie Benn. Corey Perry was with a shot. Didn't use Benn, but Benn will stay up there, or will he? Yes, he will. He'll cut across the right wing. Waiting for the pass, maybe from Corey Perry this time. Benn just sniffing the boards on the right wing. Goes all the way back, round the back of the goal. Boomister. Perry. Perry, one time, just wide of the left-hand pipe of the Swede. Chase on for Matt Duchesne. Duchesne, there's a little deflection. And then the backhander from Rick Nash, which only just marginally went wide of that left-hand pipe of Henrik Lundberg.
Canada ratcheting up the pressure now again. It was that Getzlaf line.
Through traffic once again. It's loose in front. Not for Martin St-Louis. Should have been. Maybe it could have been. Martin St-Louis within a smidgen of making it 2-0 for Canada. Really excellent opportunity for him. Not converted in front, but Canada still camped on that area. Long range blast from Alex Petriangelo. Suddenly the Canadians are ratcheting it up a bit. 17-17 now on shots. Boomista around the back of the Swedish goal. Marlowe is released by Carter. Swedes just following their men. Not able yet to get the interception. That's a good play. Really well set up by Duncan Keith for Jeff Carter. And Carter, just a little tip. Lundqvist reading it, and there's so much traffic, and now we might get a little bit of afters. Yes, Lundqvist is finding life a little bit uncomfortable in that net. Jeff Carter, again, very, very close to making it 2-0 to Canada.
Excellent slap pass by Keith. Here's the parry chance. Down the wing, good save. Henrik Lundqvist cuts down the angle, way outside the blue paint there. Nash had a chance on the backhand, but an excellent slap pass by Duncan Keith for Jeff Carter. All kinds of pressure. There's the backhand from Nash that I mentioned. Big number 61 really starting to use his size and strength. And for Jeff Carter, magnificent pass to Jonathan Toews in that first period, nearly the recipient of a magnificent pass from Keith. Here's Martin St-Louis taking advantage of his shifts. Coach Martz knows they dodged a bullet there. Canada buzzing around the Swedish crease. Remains a one-goal lead for Canada, but several chances there. Probably the best one from Carter. Nice slap pass from Duncan Keith. Knifed at the net. Lundqvist really good in that sequence for Sweden.
Crosby line out on the ice, which means that Patrice Bergeron trying to win the faceoff. Not successful yet. He'll get another chance as the puck is dropped. And Crosby following in, just pokes it wide off the goal. Thomasson down the ice, no ice, and I'll go right across the crease. There might be a little face wash as well from Carl Hagelin on Carey Price.
Smart play, Carey Price was going to move the puck for Duncan Keith, thought better of it. Have faith in your centerman that they can win the draw. Crosby will settle in there now. Hagelin's had lots of jump in this game. Give Sweden lots of credit. They collapsed in front of Lundqvist. They were under siege there, trying to hold the fort. The goalie came up big.
Might have to do again with this, with Carlson going. Oh, I was trying to go short side, but there are a couple of Canadians in the way. Retrieval work to be done by Alexander Edland. It's fallen kindly for the wraparound, maybe for Kunitz. Kunitz has come so close on so many occasions in different games to getting an important goal, but this time it's not going to happen just yet. Crosby, though, work to Duncan Keith. Keith shoots. That's the back of Johansson. Still loose out in front, all over the place at the moment, the Swedish defense not really giving the kind of protection to Henrik Lundqvist he would want.
Excellent shot block by Johansson there in a critical moment for Sweden, sacrificing his body.
Eriksson, then the low wrist and knee coming in from Johansson.
Excellent play there by Jamie Benn as well.
Here is Jamie Benn, chance to give the return compliments what he could have done on the previous play with Corey Perry. Sufferberg back down the Canadian end of the ice. The second period is rapidly running out. 6:28 remaining in the second. It's flown by. Very few stoppages, very few whistles, a few interruptions. Nice fluid hockey. It's what we want to see. Eriksson, a little backhander, which is easily claimed by Carey Price. Probably was going to go wide of the target anyway, but Carey Price making absolutely certain there was no fortuitous rebound or deflection back off the boards or indeed off the plexiglass behind.
Crosby gets down on his belly. Excellent tip pass there. Bin away to the races, tries a saucer pass to Perry. Excellent defensive work by Daniel Sedin there to break up the pass.
Sweden win the face-off. Kept in play just by Nicholas Halmarsson, but not for long for those in yellow because the Canadians can stream down the ice. Pressure from Jeff Carter. Back on the blue line, Vlasic. Jonathan Toews will work his way across the front of the net, but the clearance from Johnny Oduya under a lot of pressure again. Oduya straight into Jonathan Toews. They can play tic-tac-toe and then wide from Patrick Marleau. Chances coming thick and fast here for the Canadians, just not able yet to find a way past Henrik Lundqvist. Doughty should be able to pick up on the loose spoils here. Looking to get himself back into position and decide instead to take a line change. Landeskog dumped in. Umeister under pressure from Carl Hageland, but gets it away almost onto the blue line. Hageland's working very, very hard to try and deny Duchesne any further advancement up the ice. Petrangelo on right wing. Just hemmed back in their own end at the moment are the Canadians. They'll get it away with Nash. Petrangelo cuts across to right wing. Just plays it around the boards. It'll arrive back with Matt Duchesne. Duchesne now on the charge. Swedes have a bit of wide open ice in which to work in the center. Alfredsson. Patrick Berglund.
What a tip by Steen there. Berglund has been strong down low right there. Steen gets a tip on it. Acrobatic save there by Carey Price.
Canada just edging in front, but here's another one of those opportunities which goalies hate. They have to deal with it, and Carey Price does deal with it pretty well.
Watch his eyes tracking the puck. Takes a funny bounce on him. Smothers it there. Berglund showing his size and strength, 6'5". Steen going to the net hard as well. Carey Price equal to the task. And that gentleman there, Henrik Lundqvist, has been equal to the task. He was under siege for about a 5-minute sequence there against Canada. Both goalies, as billed, coming into this one. Excellent, excellent game so far here. The gold medal game, both goalies rising to the challenge.
They are, and there's 4:44 remaining in this period. Just that one goal, Jonathan Toews. At 12:55, assisted by Carter and Weber. Since when? Neither goalie has had their goal breached. Duncan Keith for the Canadians with Shea Weber helping, not helping out with the referee intervening. But I didn't have any real influence on how that play developed. Nicholas Cromwell, the captain, through the center of the ice for the Swedes. Haven't really mentioned him that much in commentary. And again, it's Crosby. Great chance. Well on one for Crosby. Can he score? He can! Sidney Crosby scored the winning goal in Vancouver in 2010 to give Canada gold. That may well be the goal that takes them further and further and edges them closer to 2014 gold in Sochi.
Fantastic finish, but it's a defensive play right there on Eriksson. He strips Eriksson of the puck, and he's away to the races. Sells forehand, goes backhand. Nothing Lundqvist could do. Watch the sell right here. Boom. Freezes him. Breaks some ankles. Slips it in on the backhand as Lundqvist gets big stretches out, runs out of real estate. But it was a defensive play to strip Eriksson and go off to the races there on the breakaway. An unassisted goal. Welcome to Sochi, Sidney Crosby.
Yeah, two assists before today. The goal that he and Canada have been waiting for has finally arrived. It's arrived as it did 4 years ago in dramatic fashion. He's had a more profitable time in terms of points and assists in Vancouver than he has had here. But ultimately, who's going to care if it means that goal secures them the gold medal? 3:52 remaining seconds. Sweden have to do something pretty special here. Now Doughty having a go loose in front for Jeff Carter with a follow-up.
Carlson all over Carter there. The bigger forwards, Marlow, Carter, starting to exercise their will there. Here's Crosby. Watch the defense here. Active stick in the passing lane. Away to the races with a head of steam. You're not going to catch Sidney Crosby. Sells forehand, freezes Lundqvist. Steen try and give him credit to back check. Just couldn't get there. Excellent move by Sidney Crosby, and you can see the reaction, what that meant to him.
Well, he had a breakaway of a similar kind earlier on in the tournament. Wasn't able to put it away, but cometh the art, cometh the man, and cometh the player of quality like he is to become the top point scorer in the NHL this season without being a very, very good player, as he has been, what now, for six, seven seasons in the NHL. And how would it mean, how would it feel for him to captain Canada all the way through to gold? Not there yet, still some work to do. Landeskog gets loose in front, a bit of jousting going on in front of net, but Jamie Benn will clear for the Canadians just to relieve things a little bit and ask Kjell Malmsten to go and do the chasing.
Important shift for Sweden there. They get scored on the breakaway. They come back, have a good play there. A good shot by Landeskog. So a statement shift from Sweden there that their spirit's not broken and they're certainly not going to give up. Price, a big save through traffic. Landeskog, very talented player. Fantastic player for the Colorado Avalanche. 48 points this season. Right there, Carey Price tracks the puck well. Landeskog, though, like I said, a statement shift for Sweden. Right back and attacking Canada.
Canadians will surely push for a third. They will most definitely. It's not in their DNA to think anything other than let's push on and try and turn that screw one more time. And the next time the screw is turned, that pretty much surely will see off any Swedish resistance. Still a bit of that left, though. Of course, there's going to be some wide open ice as they push forward. There's going to be certainly a whistle on the play. Down on the ice is Chris Kunitz.
Kunitz take a rough ride there right in front of the Swedish bench. You can see there face first into the dasher. Carey Price reacted quickly, got to the bench. Sweden touch it up, and you see there Tim Peel. Berglund comes in from behind. A dangerous play. You can see Berglund, lots of credit. He's been aggressive in this game, but just crosses the line here. That's from behind, and you see Kunitz's face right off the top of the dasher. Neck in an awkward position. Berglund for boarding.
Both goals for the Canadians have been even strength so far. Power play has been the least efficient part of their game, right through to the gold medal match.
Yeah, 0 for 2 in this game. A prime opportunity, though, trailing or leading 2-0 here. As you mentioned, the tighten the screw against Team Sweden. Berglund, it's good that Sweden keeps their aggression going, but you got to pick your spots there. That's right, it's center ice, right in front of the referee.
Important face-off for the Swedes to win, and they do. They cleared down the ice and ask the Canadians to bring it back. And they'll do that swiftly with Drew Doughty over the blue, over the red, working it from side to side, then putting it into the path of Shea Weber, who's on rushing down right wing. This looks good. Little, again, tic-tac-toe. Jonathan Toews and Corey Perry involved in that build-up to the net. Toews already with the opening goal for the Canadians after 12:55.
Excellent save by Lundqvist there on Toews. Canada moved the puck around well. Back against the grain by Perry. Excellent pass by Corey Perry. Unselfish as he had a shot at net. But Toews was wide open there. But Lundqvist, equal to the task. Nose trailing 2-0. He can't concede another one here.
Crosby initially won the face-off, but it finds its way back to the Swedes, who will, again, without any forward propulsion, just take it down the Canadian end of the ice. Duncan Keith under a little bit of pressure.
Good to see Kunitz back out there as well. He took that big hit from Berglund, had a bloody nose, but back out there. Hockey players are made of tough stuff.
So they are. Keith back on defensive duties. Crosby with Kunitz. And he also has the option of Jeff Carter as well. Carter will work his way back over his blue line, in between the blue and the red, and wait for that pass, which might eventually come. The Swedes have it, though, and can force it down the ice. Duncan Keith in front of his own net. Corey Perry down left wing. Not the option he takes. He goes for Alex Petriangelo instead. And the Swedes just happy to get it as far away from their own net as they can. Waste a few more valuable seconds. Give them a chance for a line change. Give them a chance for a reassessment of the situation. Here's Duncan Keith with Taves and with Corey Perry. Perry waits at the top of the circle and works his way in. Swedes have it though. And we have on the table of Jimmy Eriksson, who lets one go well wide of the target. No real alarm for Carey Price. Just watch that fly by his left-hand post. Jonathan Taves for the Canadians. Power play is done. Not before the shot from Doughty, which takes a huge deflection en route to goal. Still out of possession, though. Down the Swedish end of the ice for Corey Perry. Getzlaff. Getzlaff held into the boards by Jimmy Eriksson. Any resolution for that? Well, the referee says keep playing it, because I can still see it. There's one, two, three, four players in the corner. That's enough three Swedes trying to extricate that puck, but the Canadians may still come up with it. And Ryan Getzlaff said, well, there's nothing much going to happen for me there, so I'm going to go and leave it to the others. Marlow. Mr. Brunt hiccups the one-timer from Boomeister. And that will bring to a conclusion the end of the second period at the Bolshoi Ice Dome. Canada are much closer than they were to their goal. They lead 2-0. World champions against the Olympic winners of 4 years ago. Can the Swedes find a way back in? They have 20 minutes remaining. Swedes attacking the goal to our left, argued by Carey Price. And Swedes have Henrik Larsson between the, Henrik Lundqvist between the pipes for them. They'll need something early, you think. They'll have to find a goal from somewhere just to put some pressure on Canada, who don't seem to be under any pressure at all, even when there's been those little pockets of play where the Swedes have dominated. The Canadians have lapped it all up. They've soaked it all up. They haven't really looked under pressure.
Exactly what they did against Team USA, keep things to the outside. And exactly like he did against Team USA, Carey Price has been really good, smothering rebounds. Not too many chances on rebounds for Team Sweden. Drew Doughty's been magnificent, 15 minutes, 3 seconds of ice time. And Martin St. Louis, only 5 minutes and 12 seconds of ice time, but 3 shots on goal, so he's been good.
Here's a face-off the Swedes would like to win. They'd like to win it with a slightly more straightforward chance of getting the puck back to advance it. Through the likes of Louis Eriksson, but they're not going to, because the Canadians have a rush and they have a chance to maybe put this game out of reach. Once again, the shot from Jonathan Taves. Waiting for the loose spoils. The rebound to come back out was Jeff Carter.
Excellent transition by Canada. Taves, it was a 2-on-1 development. He goes for the shot, knows if there's any rebound, Carter will be there, but great goaltending there by Henrik Lundqvist. Taves with his first goal in the gold medal game. Crosby with his first goal of Sochi as well. Two big game players coming to the front.
Face off. Dribbles all the way back over the red, over the blue, and back into the defensive zone for the Canadians, who will have to advance it, and they'll quickly get it out with Drew Doughty. Pass intended to be chased by Sidney Crosby, but Swedes have it with Hagland. Three of them come out in formation. Jonathan Eriksson looking for Hagland again to put some pressure on the net occupied by Carey Price.
Good play by Marcus Kruger, going to the net hard, looking for a rebound there. Hard-nosed player. And that's what Coach Martz will need. Guys going to the net. Price has been smothering rebounds, but eventually he's going to give up one, and you need someone right there to capitalize.
Ekman Larsson down on the ice. I do a double take there. I'm going, there's a number three out there. Here he is.
This is a guy with a lot of points in the NHL. 8 goals, 21 assists for the Phoenix Coyotes. Martz giving him a shift here. Didn't play at all against Finland.
Well, he hasn't got the deepest of benches now because he's lost a couple of players, a couple of key players as well. So he has to get a man like him involved in the play. And he knows that time is not on his side in terms of turning this game around. He has to have the players who can do it, like this advance of Niklas Hjalmarsson. Work his way forward is Landis Skog. That score will be put under a lot of pressure, not just by one player, but by two, and there's no other Swedes there to help out the Swedish progression towards the Canada net. Taves stole away from him by Berglund. Berglund might have to do a lot of work here by himself. Carlsen will advance into the corner. Here comes the one-timer from Nicholas Cromwell. And Cromwell then has to go back and do defensive duties alongside Gabriel Landeskog, or indeed trying to stop Patrick Marleau. There's nobody to lay the puck off to wearing a red shirt at the moment, though, so the Swedes should be able to clear this fairly comfortably. Maybe not. Nash. Doughty hits the pipe, comes back out. Martin St-Louis was waiting right there for any rebound. If he'd come back off the goalie, he might have got it. It came back off the pipe, though, at Duchesne. Edler takes the deflection, won't be icing, so it'll need to be played by Drew Doughty. Doughty plays it behind him, Vlasic. He's deep in their own zone, but doing well to make sure the Swedes don't get any quality possession until Edler was the man hovering around the front of the crease. Eriksson in the corner for the Swedes. Sedin, make himself available. We'll wait for the shot to come in and maybe pick up on that rebound. Not going to happen this time, and the Swedes will go back to halfway and make their change in personnel. Hagelin just couldn't slice his way through that Canadian defence, just taking off left and didn't have the puck under control. Meanwhile, back at the other end, they've gone offside, have Canada, as Kunitz was bringing it over the blue line. Clock stops, 3:13, end of period number three.
Big shot by Drew Doughty. Takes a bounce in front. Off the post to Shane. Trying to get a tip on it there. Cronwall boxes him out, can't get to the rebound. At the other end, we saw Carlson, Erik Karlsson already jumping in. Gabriel Landeskog had to come back and play defenses. Erik Karlsson already jumping into the rush, already trying to play a bit of offense for Team Sweden.
Canadians have it down their own end of the ice, but they can just take their time over progressing it this time. No great rush with Duncan Keith and Drew Doughty. In the back of the Swedish net to be won back by Getzlaff, possibly. With some help from Patrick Marleau. Won't clear the zone, the Swedes. They still won't, because it'll be kept in by Corey Perry. Perry there to help out. Jamie Benn tied up in the corner. Swedes will get it away, but that's going to be an icing call, and they're going to come all the way back. Just lacking a few ideas here, Sweden, about how to slice their way through this Canadian defence, because at this stage, they've got nothing to show for it. There's a man who's only just had his first shift in this game, and indeed over the last two games.
Yeah, didn't play at all in the semi-final. Here, fresh legs, necessary, trailing 2-0. And as I mentioned, Erik Karlsson already joining the rush heavily for Sweden.
Crosby trying to go short side. There isn't any room available to him. The left of the goal occupied by Lundqvist. Now, here's the man who's had much of a look in recent times, Oliver Ekman-Larsen. Is there anybody else wearing a yellow shirt who wants to pick up on that puck? Not at that end of the ice, there isn't. Cromwell, the captain. That's where they need the rush, and they need the rush quickly, and they need somebody to latch onto it who can advance it. Daniel Alfredsson was playing the playmaker role through the center. As we look at Patrick Berglund.
He's been hard to handle for Canada. Big body presence. Certainly a guy that needs to go to the net hard now. You see Nyquist go to the net. He actually hit the post in the first period, Nyquist, so they're going to have to start jumping in front of Carey Price.
Cromwell is wide open. Oh, nearly was. This pass didn't come in his direction. Jeff Carter now to surely put the game out of reach. Just forced further wide. The short side, Patrick Marleau digging away there. Got the first shot in. Save made by Lundqvist in the corner for Doughty to extricate it. Left wing, Vlasic. Back around the boards for Jeff Carter. All Canadian possession, though. Swedes aren't getting a look in. Jonathan Taves does well to just put the brakes on and move back in the other direction. They're trying to walk it in. Doughty Swedes need to clear it, and they do clear it. But just no quality in terms of possession and trying to get it over that Canadian blue line. It's going to come all the way back. Line changes made on both sides. 14-38 remaining in the third. Jamie Benn for the Canadians. A little wrist shot. Has to take a stick with him this time. Weber. Benn and Perry will try and combine. Benn around the back of the net. Ryan Getzlaff arriving on left wing. Corey Perry. Getzlaff again has worked it out loose. He's moving away from goal, so wasn't able to give the accurate pass he was hoping for. Perry will return the compliment. It looks like they're playing a power play here, Canada. They're not being closed down as yet. And there's Corey Perry with the attempt to try and lodge that puck in the bottom left-hand corner of Henrik Lundqvist's net. And now it's getting a bit fruity between Gabriel Landeskog and Ryan Getzlaff.
Eriksson took exception there to Getzlaff, giving Daniel Alfredsson a shove as the ice crew come out. The Canadian forwards starting to exert their will against a tired defense corps now. That's why you see Oliver Ekman-Larsson getting some shifts in the third period for Sweden. Canada leaning, forechecking hard, leaning on the defense. And that line, Taves with a wraparound chance trying to get that third goal for Canada. Every time into the Swedish zone, these bigger forwards. Here's the wraparound by Taves. Carter in front, Marlowe in front. These are 6'2", 6'3" forwards. Really hard to contain for the Swedish defense. And Oliver Ekman-Larsson didn't play at all against Finland, didn't play in the first or second period here in the gold medal game. He's out for his third shift now. Here's Perry, this wave after wave of red shirts now. There's Getzlaff, gave Daniel Alfredsson a little shot. Jonathan Eriksson jumped in there as well as some tempers boil over, some frustrations for Sweden. But Canada come with a heavy forecheck. They're leaning on Sweden. They're leaning on those defensemen who are a little bit tired. Oliver Ekman-Larsson coming out here for some shifts. Going to need to tack up and get some moments in here, get some rest for the other defensemen.
28-1, 21 now is the shots on goal for the Canadians, very much in the ascendant on the scoreboard in pretty much every single respect. Now, can the Swedes do something to prevent another attack? Finding it very hard to close the Canadians down. They seem to have so many options and so many outlets for the pass. Vlasic comes back in from Shea Weber. Always in and around the front of that goal. Never too far away with those shots from close range. Crosby looking comfortable, looking confident. Getting the passes right onto the tapes of sticks. He might have to do a lot more work on this shift to try and make an opening. And they've decided that they'll shift off the ice to give another line a chance to see if they can do something. Steen goes backhand across the front of the Canadian goal. It's only a little kind of range finder in a way. Just hoping perhaps there might be a deflection or somebody following in, but not to be at the moment. And the Swedes do seem to be running out of ideas. Shea Weber has accumulated 3 goals in the tournament.
He's had an excellent tournament. Big assist here on the opening goal by Taves. Short shifts now for Canada, up, down, and off. Fresh legs, the key here, as they continue to stifle and trap through the neutral zone and lean on Sweden in their own end.
Will be icy on that. It will need to be played and brought away by Alexander Steen to Cromwell, the captain. Will now make his way through the center of the ice. Just forced into the corner, but should be claimed quite comfortably by Jay Boumister. And then helped still further away. Only one man back on defensive duties. That is Cromwell. Of course, never mind, waiting to see how this might develop. Petrangelo and Carlson in the corner. Away comes Patrick Berglund.
Excellent hustle there. Sorry, Bob. Excellent hustle by Taves to beat Cronwall to that loose puck. So right now, Canada are coming actually harder than they did even in the second period against Sweden.
Trapping Sweden down their own end. Not allowing any easy way to escape. As we have a look at Rick Nash, 29 years of age. New York Rangers these days. Winner in 2010.
It's his best game today for sure. He was good against USA. He's really had jump using his size, creating offense for Team Canada.
Just waiting for the Swedes to just find something new, something different, something a bit more inventive. It's not happening at the moment. In fact, what they're doing is more often than not coughing the puck up around the front of their net, or in the region of their net anyway. Ripped around the boards by Martin Eriksson, but it's going to come back with interest for the Canadians, and Nash is going to have a go. And that's a tester, a real nasty one for Henrik Lundqvist to have to deal with. And just kind of emphasizing and underlining what you were saying a few moments ago, Rick Nash has really stepped up to the plate today.
Well, that's a harder shot to deal with than it looked like. Long-range shot, but Rick Nash got all of his 220 pounds behind that. Look at that. It's in the glove, in and out, before Lundqvist can react. But Lundqvist, so quick, quick as a cat, covers up there. Certainly the best game of the tournament from Rick Nash.
Swedes will be aware that 11:44 is all that remains in the game. That's what remains in terms of their hopes of getting the gold medal again, like they did against the Canadians in 1994. Perry, first attempt on the goal occupied by Henrik Larsson on that shift, and Henrik Larsson makes the save.
Perry, Getzlaff, and Ben, a handful since Mike Babcock put them together in the round robin portion of the tournament. Excellent here today.
Well, when the Swedes need some shots, they're being outshot 7-1. That shows you just how one-sided in terms of possession period number three is turning out to be. The Swedes just are not making any tracks out of their own end often enough. Anyway, Eriksson loses the edge, so a player is down for the count for a moment. He gets himself back in an upright position. Ryan Getzlaff. Corey Perry will find Oliver Ekman Larsson right on top of him, but there's a few more valuable seconds wasted, a bit more possession wasted as well, and then it pings and finds its way through, and that will be the goal from Chris Kunitz that will do it for the Canadians. Went off the metalwork, and Chris Kunitz had been trying and trying so very hard, game after game after game, to find a route through the defenses of various teams. At long last, hits the jackpot against Sweden.
Cough up in the neutral zone there by Sedin. Kunitz sharks into the zone. Hjalmarsson goes down. Lundqvist doesn't see it till it's too late. Bar down. 3-0 Canada. Kunitz had taken a lot of heat. Almost a smile from Babcock. I say almost. Furrowed brow, but a timeout now for Sweden. Chris Kunitz had taken a lot of heat for his inability to bury the puck here in Sochi. Right there, that's a huge goal right there. An extra insurance goal for Canada. Turnover in the neutral zone as Canada is stifling, coming hard. Taking away all this time and space in the neutral zone for Sweden. And Kunitz, with Johnny on the spot, uses Hjalmarsson as a screen. Bar down. You can see what that means. Relief. He knows that he came here to score, to play well against alongside Sidney Crosby, against the opposition. Finally, gets on the board.
Two unassisted goals for the Canadians. Sidney Crosby at 35-43, and now Chris Kunitz at 49-04. Now, surely that has got to be an insurmountable task now for the Swedes. Certainly if a fourth goes in, they might as well say good night, thank you very much, and it's been fun. But they won't have that mindset. They'll be looking for a way through, but they're not going to find a way through while the Canadians are having the kind of possession they're having. Yet again, Patrick Marleau going wide with that in that attempt. One from eight shots. That kind of sums up the tournament that Chris Kunitz has been having up to this stage. But all that will be forgotten when they look at the details of the scoring in this game.
Continued pressure from Canada in the neutral zone, all over Louis Eriksson. There was Duncan Keith. Eriksson looked like he was going to break out, and Canada just moved forward on him, stifling through the neutral zone now, stifling in their own zone. And certainly that forecheck of Canada is big and mean, and it's just heavy on Sweden right now. And that's why a guy like Oliver Ekman Larsson, we've said it a few times, didn't play in the first two periods when Sweden had lots of energy. But Canada, wave after wave of the red shirts in the Swedish zone, wearing Sweden down systematically.
It's not in the Swedish psyche normally to give up, but they must be feeling battered and bruised and rather hemmed in. And there's going to be a penalty on the Canadians here. So power play coming for the Swedes. Henrik Lundqvist only just realized that as the whistle was blown.
I think Lundqvist is tired as well, though he a late jump out of the net there. He's been excellent because a 3-0 scoreline, it hasn't been as one side as that. I mean, a couple of the Crosby goal was a breakaway, and certainly the play, the defensive play of Canada has been crippling to Sweden. But Sweden's had their chances. Price has been good. None of the goals really Lundqvist's fault. Perry sticks out a hip. Interference right there. Takes down Edler. It's a tripping call. There's nothing Lundqvist could do. He actually played the Crosby breakaway perfectly. He got a toe on it, but Crosby was not going to be denied on that. And that shot by Chris Kunitz was a perfect shot off the bar and in. Certainly now it's time to roll four men into the zone. You're going to see Erik Karlsson double shift. And right now, a power play with Corey Perry. So if they can get one back, there's still 9:48 to go. There's plenty of hockey to play in this gold medal game. But that heavy forecheck and that stifling play in the neutral zone is really taking its toll on Team Sweden.
Good job done by Mike Babcock and by his team. They really haven't given Sweden a sniff, really, in period number three, just when they needed to kind of ramp it up a bit, look a little bit more aggressive, a bit more intuitive. Swedes have found the Canadians a very hard nut to crack. But they have a chance here. They have a 2-minute power play with Corey Perry sitting in the penalty box. And the face-off, good news for the Swedes, actually starts at the Canadian end of the ice as well. So if something's going to happen, it's a big, big ask, then this is a place where it needs to start to happen. Bergeron will be in the face-off circle, looks like, with Louis Eriksson. Not sure what we're waiting for in terms of
extensive repairs. Lundqvist has been at the bench since he went on the delayed penalty. Something wrong with that trapper. He's getting some lacing done there, preparing for this last 9:48.
Right, well, he's back in goal. We can get things underway. Face-offs won 26-26. That doesn't mean a great deal. Well, it's now 27-26 in Canada's favour anyway. Most of the stats that are important, the ones that matter, are right now. And it could be a shorthanded goal as well for the Canadians. Just to add insult to injury, Patrice Bergeron and Jamie Benn trying to combine. Here is Bergeron trying to work it out of the corner. You see how much the Swedes need this, how much they want it. Two men right on top, because they're out of position now. They haven't advanced the puck at all yet. Now they will out from their goal line with Karlsson. He'll take it through the center. They need something a bit swift. They need something with a bit more penetration. And at the moment, all they seem to be doing is giving the puck back to the likes of Jamie Benn. Jamie Benn says, no, I've had enough on this shift. Thank you very much indeed. I'm getting off. Karlsson for the Swedes. Now, how direct does he want to be? He's going to rip it around the boards. Steen is on right wing. Eriksson is joining him there, but immediately there are three Canadians in and around the puck, and they just smother it again and clear it again.
It's absolute systematic right now, and even on the penalty kill, they're aggressive. Jamie Benn just ran over Louis Eriksson, absolutely ran over him. Ex-Dallas Stars teammates, no love lost there. And Benn all over Sweden on the penalty kill.
Berglund then helped on his way by Boumeister. In a yellow shirt is actually in a position to do anything here, and the answer is nobody. It has a strange roll and bounce and bobble, does the puck. So we need to get it back under control and need to get their own play back under control. Here's Edler. I thought he was going to go for the shot then, just was in kind of two minds, and Jamie Benn will come back the other end, and Benn! Oh, a chance for four. Hit the metalwork and came right back out. I was waiting for that net to bulge. He was waiting for it too. But didn't quite happen this time. Let's say it won't happen in the remaining 7:49. Because remember, that was the Swedes on a power play. And nothing happened.
Coming out party for Jamie Benn. We know he's a good hockey player. He's the leader of the Dallas Stars. 22 goals, 51 points in the NHL. This has been an absolute coming out party for Jamie Benn, showing everybody his defensive prowess, his physical prowess. He's had timely goals in this tournament. What a penalty kill sequence there for Canada and Jamie Benn.
Swedes will again follow into the corner, but without all the kind of real belief that they had earlier in the game. Crosby Bobbling, bouncing puck to be dealt with by Kunin. Ooh, not quite sure what he was intending to do there. Martin Saint-Louis held into the boards by Jonathan Eriksson. Will work its way loose for the team in yellow. Cromwell needs something to happen here quickly. Advancing it to Silverberg. Silverberg under pressure immediately from Jamie Benn, just keeping it tight to the boards on left wings. There's no obvious way of escaping. Hjalmarsson. Eriksson. Again, smothered by two or three Canadians. Just allowing them no time on the puck, no time to compose themselves, no time to look up and see what the options are, because immediately they are trapped.
Absolutely wonderful performance. If you thought Canada's defensive performance couldn't get any better than it did against Team USA, the best offense possibly in the entire tournament, shut them out 1-0. It's been even better today and even more physical. You see Dowdy there go after Haglund.
How do they try? Well, that seems to happen from a Swedish point of view. It'll be one of those kind of little nasty wristers that get a deflection just to get the Swedes on the board if it's going to come at all. And the Canadians shut out the USA. Yeah, they do likewise with the Swedes, who have to find at least something in the next minute, you think, just to keep this game competitive, because Canada basically brought the drawbridge down and not allow them anywhere near their castle right now.
Mentioned Jamie Benn, an absolute warrior on the power play, on the penalty kill rather. Made it look like a power play. Good save there by Lundqvist. Gets a piece of it up and into the meshing. Patrice Bergeron's had a wonderful tournament for Team Canada. But today, three guys who hadn't scored in the tournament all get on the board. Another chance, Bergeron. But Taves hadn't scored, Crosby hadn't scored, Kunitz hadn't scored. Those are the three goal scorers. Some work being done on Corey Perry's shoulders. He's been physical in this one, but winning makes everything feel better. You see there, it gets run over shoulder to shoulder by Jimmy Eriksson. A win here will make that shoulder feel pretty good for Corey Perry.
Well, when Sweden needs shots on goal, how many do you think they've got in period number three? Two.
It's just been a sea of red. Sweden's trying. They haven't given up. They just cannot penetrate Canada every time in their own zone. It's almost like a penalty kill. They've got the four-man box and then a guy chasing the puck.
Eriksson again, having to do a lot of chasing to even have a 50-50 opportunity, which this one doesn't become because the Canadians have it back again. Bergeron plays it into the corner. Crosby, wouldn't it be just right for him to score the ultimate winning goal here? Well, I suppose the game was out of sight when the first goal went in, regarding the scoreline anyway, but Crosby, for all his efforts during the course of Sochi 2014, probably deserves to get another look in. An unassisted goal gave him a 2-0 advantage. Unassisted goal by Kunitz giving him a 3-0 advantage. This has all been about Canada. Sweden have hardly had a sniff, apart from that first period, which was really nip and tuck and quite competitive.
Sweden have kept coming hard. They haven't given up. Berglund's been good. Steen has been good, but they just can't penetrate. They can't get to Price. And when they do, Price is not allowing any rebounds. It's just a dominant defensive performance right now by Canada.
Cromwell was cocking the stick, ready for the shot, just on the blue line. They need to stop the advance of Jamie Benn this time. And the Canadians just break out at will from the Swedish end of the ice. Jamie Benn, Corey Perry, and Benn. Corey Perry at the back of the net now. Getzlaff will take over duties and will look for, I think he was going to look for the wraparound initially, but he was going in the wrong direction, so couldn't do that. Perry, laid off by Petrangelo. This looks like a scrimmage. The Canadians are not under any kind of pressure as yet. And when they are at the other end, they have the ever-dependable Carey Price and Alex Petrangelo to bring it out of defense. The Canadians will feel very comfortable. The fans most certainly will now. Jeff Carter passes off the boards, met by Lundqvist. Sets Ekman Larsson on his way. Helped out by Hageland. Again, they've coughed it up.
It's unbelievable pressure. Every time Sweden gets to their own blue line, there's three Canadian shirts.
Hjalmarsson. Jimmy Eriksson. As soon as there's a just a sniff of a loose puck. There's a Canadian right on top of it. And the Swedes, for the most part in this competition, have had loads of time to settle, loads of time to control what they want to do, work out the next play, work beyond the next play. And it's almost like immediately that it's a wasp or there's an insect flying around going, oh, well, there's a guy right in my slipstream straight away every single time.
A lot of credit has to go to Ralph Kruger, brought in here as a consultant by Mike Babcock.
Shot from distance from Jonsson Eriksson.
Kruger was brought in as a consultant to help Canada shake off that whole issue about the big ice. Can they play on the big ice? Can they put a system in place? Ralph Kruger has helped Mike Babcock and his coaching staff. This is a master class on defensive play in all three zones by Canada.
Eriksson gets a hit from Chris Kunitz. It still means a lot to him to take the Swede out, even though this game is almost done and dusted. I'm trying to be optimistic from a Swedish point of view, but very hard to see a route back into it. 3:40 remaining in the game. And Edler will have to play it because he's under pressure from Bergeron. Ben gets a bit of a push and shove, but it really doesn't matter at this stage with Eriksson. Now making a charge to ascend the ice is Hagelund. Steen, and Hagelund's gone offside. 35 shots to 23 accumulatively from Canada. I think Sweden's still just with a two, in fact, no, three now in period number three.
Canada's blocked three or four shots in this period too, though. Jonsson Toews has two blocks alone in this period. So Canada collapsing down low, not letting anything get through, and anything that does get through is coming from distance, as mentioned, and Carey Price, no rebounds at all for the Swedes today.
Last 3 minutes of the men's ice hockey tournament at Sochi 2014. I think we were thinking this would be a much tighter final than it has ultimately turned out to be. Yes, there's a sting in the tail, which is not evident right now. Kruger, the pass round the back of the Canadian net, but everything's coming from the perimeter, nothing's coming direct. Now it might do. Shot took a deflection. Hjalmarsson it was with the initial shot. It took all the way off it, and that deflection into the corner. Nyquist back with Hjalmarsson. The Canadians are already starting to celebrate. It's not premature, believe me, the way things are looking. They could add another quite comfortably. Swedes just looking to open their account and not getting any closer. The 2:25 remaining in the game. Cromwell, disappointing day for him, disappointing day for the Swedes.
Canada again, Marlow, one man in and then four shirts across. Sweden just not able to break out at all on Canada in this third period.
It's been a masterclass executed by Mike Babcock. Last 2 minutes of Olympic ice hockey in Sochi. We know which way the gold medal's going. And if there's just one more Canadian breach of the Swedish net before things are done and dusted. They'd like another one. They're always looking for another one. And whilst they've been absolutely stoic on defence, they've taken their chances when they have come. Carlson, again, it's going to be turned over. Rick Nash. Nash! No rebound for anybody in red this time. Good attempt close in by Rick Nash.
Look at the back check by Nash. He leads the rush because of the neutral zone clog, which he actually started against Sweden. Goes down, has a chance, and then back checks. Excellent, excellent shift by Rick Nash.
Ryan Getzlaff held into the boards by Eriksson. Center ice, they lose the puck. And a minute and four to go on the game. A game that has long since gone for Sweden with that Chris Kunitz goal really just putting the tin lid on it.
Smile by Jonsson Toews there. Crosby, a little bit of a smile there. Knows there's still a minute four to go here. But Kunitz, Crosby, and Toews. First goal of Sochi. Couldn't have come at a better time for Team Canada.
It's the last minute. And Canada still working hard like they have been all the way through. That's been the ethic of this team. That's why the team has got the job done and got the job done in style. Will they come back to give their fans one more thing to cheer? Well, the big thing to cheer will be in 35 seconds when they will once again be the gold medalists at the Winter Olympic Games as they were in Vancouver in 2010. 2014 has been similarly profitable for them.
Tillinder touches, finally a shift for Tillinder. He wasn't going to play. Of course, Backstrom, a last minute scratch for Team Sweden. Crosby, the captain, finally allows a smile there. Stanley Cup champion, Olympic hero, overtime hero in Vancouver. Big goal here in this gold medal game.
Been nowhere near as tight, nowhere near as gripping, nowhere near as enthralling. But they won't care how they get the job done. They very much have got the job done, Canada, by being good at both ends. They're not going to find a way past the defenses of Carey Price. They're just going to dribble it all the way down to the other end of the ice. And Canada, once again, for the ninth time in winter and summer Olympic history, have won the gold medal in men's ice hockey. It is a double. The women won against the USA. That was nowhere near as convincing as this has been by Canada against Sweden. A goal in each period, and ultimately they were so much better than the Swedes. When it came down to it, it was finished. Sweden 0, Canada 3.